what are some of the positives and negatives, basically like the constrictions of working in a like virtual production environment? Because obviously things like film pickup, like if you're doing a location shoot, you know, you're not going to be able to go all the way back out there and do it all over again, plus capture the same type of day, time and day, and weather and everything else. Like, I was just curious to kind of, if you want to give like the quick rundown on pros and cons of, or limitations of virtual production versus soundstage and obviously outdoor location.
Yeah, absolutely. So assuming that you've decided against shooting on location, like you want to bring it in studio and you're looking for that cost benefit and you're looking for that, you know, theoretically performance benefit, people can actually take their time to do, you know, their dialogue driven scenes and performances and that type of stuff. You're bringing it in the studio. So you've got to decide between a standing set, green screen, a video plate, which is most commonly used for car shoots, and then this type of virtual production, which we call in-camera effects. It's also sometimes called XR filmmaking, which is basically a fancy way to say mixed reality filmmaking, where like the photons are actually coming into the lens of the camera from the screen, that type of thing. So you're going to be making your choice between these four options, and the way that you're going to make your choice is basically based on the type of aesthetic that you'd like to achieve for that shot. The reality is that when you actually get filmmakers in a room and you give them the option to not use green screen, they'll most often take it, just because there's a lots of unknown issues with green screen just from an aesthetic standpoint. Now, some directors are very comfortable with the technology and they know how to get the look, or they know that their DP and visual effects supervisor can get the look and they're comfortable with that. But a lot of times, LED backdrops with video plates or virtual production are going to be something that people choose because there's lots of reflective surfaces, glass, smoke, liquids, or in instances where you have complicated stunts and you want to get that additional level of realism in the scenario. The other reason that you're going to choose in-camera effects versus these other options is if there's a very short amount of post-production time and you want to get an effects-heavy shot. So a good example of that would be sports broadcasting. It's not something that a lot of filmmakers think about, but you can think of it as they often have access to the athletes only for about one day, a couple weeks prior to when the season begins. It's a press day. So on that day, they'll often bring them in front of a virtual production setup, capture them in front of that setup so that there's a very minimal amount of post-production involved in completing that footage in time for the season to begin. So that's like an excellent example of where virtual production can really cut things down. Driving plates and LED backdrops are generally only at this point mainly used for driving and in vehicle shooting. The difference that people choose mainly for between standing sets and virtual production, and mostly has to do with cost, to be honest. We've been really lucky, and the quality of sets that you can deliver with virtual production has skyrocketed in, I would say, like the past couple of years, particularly with the release of Unreal Engine 5, which has a more advanced way of dealing with realistic lighting. We're competing directly with standing sets, which is a really exciting thing to say. Even I think 3 years ago, there's definitely a question of whether the real-time engines would ever get there. I think that question is kind of over and people have seen it deliver. So now, you know, the question is, what is the ease and usability of the technology? And that's mostly where we're focused when we're talking about this versus other technologies with clients. And one of the things that we do as virtual production supervisors is we actually look at scripts and we'll recommend, here's where you use us versus other technologies. We have no problem turning the screen green so that you can get that master shot that would be otherwise be difficult to get using the technology. Most of the time it has to do with water, to be honest. Like, you need a water tank, and we don't have one, so you're gonna have to figure out how to do that in another way. No,
it's really great. Like, it's definitely opened up a lot of doors, and I personally haven't been involved in any virtual production on-set shoots yet, but I've got a lot of friends who are either directors or souping shows where, it's definitely given a lot of freedom to what they're doing and dealing with. I'd love to chat about feature film and more of the, let's just say, premium services as well as products, but starting out more on a consumer level, who is the target market there? Is it like indie filmmakers and, as you mentioned before, streamers or people like that potentially, or for more of the consumer level products that you're putting out, like who is the target market for that?
Yeah, it's a great question. It's also, as we move into a broader market, into the prosumer space, it also gets a lot more difficult to answer, because what really the only thing that ties them together is that they're interested in taking their story outside of normal spaces that they've been constrained in. So that is anything from small marketing teams that are putting out live stream content, commercial content, to YouTubers, to even people who are doing content generation for small organizations, just like internal production and that type of stuff. It's really all over the place, and it's difficult to answer. But where we see a lot of the growth happening is definitely in folks that have an existing audience who are interested in expanding the scope or the production value of what those audiences perceive from their channels and from their brand, and continuing to deliver at that heightened level, being able to combine their performances with extravagant set pieces and locations and effects and that type of stuff, and conceivably down the line also digital crowds and characters and that type of stuff, which I think is some of the exciting stuff that's coming down the pipe.
That's great.